All right, so first off, I want to say thank you to everyone that showed up and watched the video. Not like us, reaction. 28K? Holy shit. I really appreciate that. You guys showed up in droves and brought my sub count up, you know. And a lot of you asked me to react to Meet the Grams. So, we're going to do that. I'm becoming more of a fan of Kendrick Lamar. Like I was before, you know, because I heard Humble and a few other tracks. But Not Like Us, like, that cemented him. His legacy, no one can touch him. Like, don't go up to the GOAT and try to, you know, poke. Because you're going to get leveled. You're going to get buried. And, you know, so we're going to get into this. First time reacting to Meet the Grams. All right, let's get to it.
Dear Adonis, I'm sorry that that man is your father, let me be honest. It takes a man to be a man, your dad is not responsive. I look at him and wish your grandpa would have wore a condom. I'm sorry that you gotta grow up and then stand.
Ooh, saying I wish to wore a condom, so that's fucking brutal.
Behind them, life is hard, I know. The challenges always go beat us home. Sometimes our parents make mistakes that affect us until we grown. And you're a good kid that need good leadership. Let me be your mentor, since your daddy don't teach you shit. Never let a man piss on your leg, son. Either you die right there or pop that man in the head, son. Never fall in the escort business, that's bad religion. Please remember, you could be a bitch even if you got bitches. Never code switch, whether right or wrong. You're a black man.
Kendrick, you're wild. Holy shit. Oh, come on. Man, I gotta go back. Oh, man.
Even if you got bitches, never code switch, whether right or wrong. You're a black man, even if it don't benefit your goals. Do some push-ups, get some discipline. Don't cut them corners like your daddy did. Fuck what Ozempic did. Don't pay to play with them Brazil.
If you don't know Ozempic, everyone's trying to take the cheat code and, you know, get fit through shit like that. Instead of going and fucking putting in the fucking work. You want abs? You do sit-ups. You do crunches. You do planks. You fucking put the fucking work in. You put the work in the gym or even at home. And in the fucking kitchen. But saying they're taking cheat way out, they're taking Ozempic to fucking get fit while still eating like shit. There's a lot of people like that, and you know, it's facts. You go to the gym, you're gonna get that if you put in the fucking work. Blood, sweat, and tears. Yeah, sometimes blood, you know, you're ripping calluses off if you're deadlifting or you're fucking lifting dumbbells, like, because that happens. It's part of the process. That's where you get your fucking discipline. Facts.
Silly hands, get a gym membership. Understand, no throwing rocks and hiding hands, that's law. Don't be ashamed about who you with, that's how he treats your moms. Don't have a kid to hide again, be sure. 5% will comprehend, but 95 is lost. Be proud of who you are. Your strength come from within. A lot of superstars, that's real. But your daddy ain't one of them. And you nothing like him. You'll carry yourself as king. Can't understand me right now. Just play this when you 18. Dear Sandra, your son got some habits, I hope you don't undermine them. Especially with all the girls that's hurt inside this climate. You a woman, so you know how it feels to be in alignment. With emotion, hoping a man can see you and not be blinded. Dear Dennis, you gave birth to a master manipulator. Even using you to prove who he is a huge favor. I think you should ask for more paper, and more paper, and more, more paper. I'm blaming you for all his gambling addictions. Psychopath intuition, the man that like to play victim. You raised a horrible fucking person. The nerve of you, Dennis. Sandra, sit down. What I'm about to say is heavy. Now listen. Your son's a sick man with sick thoughts. I think niggas like him should die. Him and Weinstein should get fucked up in a cell for the rest of their life. He hates black women, hypersexualizing with kinks of a nympho fetish. Grew facial hair because he understood being a beard just fit him better. He got sex offenders on Hovio that he keep on a monthly allowance. And a child should never be compromised, and he keeping his child around him. And we gotta raise our daughters knowing there's predators like him lurking. Fuck a rap battle, he should die so all of these women can live with a purpose. I've been in this industry 12 years, I'ma tell y'all one little secret. It's some weird shit going on, and some of these artists be here to police it. They be
fucking facts. There's some weird ass motherfuckers in the music industry. It's not just fucking rap, hip hop industry. It's like all fucking over. I seen some shady shit. Like, you know, some of you may not know. You know, I interact with a lot of artists, and a lot of the artists I've interacted with are straight up like the most level-headed, cool people. But you see other bands that you don't interact with, they're doing shady ass shit. They're doing some fucking wild ass shit. It's like, what the fuck is going on? A lot of people, you know, it's a lot of fucked up people out there. Luckily, I haven't personally run into them, but I've seen it afar, if that makes sense. Not to point fingers at certain people, but everyone that I've interacted with doing filming or interviewing or doing podcasts or whatever, well, not whatever, but you know what I mean, like, I've been lucky and fortunate. A lot of these musicians are fucking awesome. So, that's besides the point. Like, well, the fact is, like, what I'm trying to get at, I imagine you understand where I'm coming from. Because, certain people will tell you we have to do certain things. And I've been told that personally, to do certain things, in order to get anywhere. And I don't play that shit. I do not. No. I don't give a fuck who you are. I don't care if you're biggest fucking musician or someone one tier or whatever. Fuck that. I'm gonna fucking pave my own way. That's how artists should be. Pave your own way. And if you're honest, you'll be fine. If you're shady, it's going to come out. And right here, Lamar's shedding light on that.
Streamlining victims on the side of their home and calling them tender. Then leak videos, sell themselves to further.
So you use that double, like, tender, but from Tinder. Yeah, I'm reading into it. That was good. I like that line.
To push their agendas. To any woman that be playing this music, know that you're playing your sister, or better yet, selling your niece to the weirdos, not the good ones. Cat Williams, I gave you the truth, so I'ma get mine.
Yep, Cat Williams. He's a real one. Real motherfucker. Funny ass comedian. A true speaker, too.
The embassy about to get raided too. It's only a matter of time. Hey, LeBron, keep the family away. Hey, Curry, keep the family away. To anybody that embody the love for their kids, keep the family away. They looking at you too if you're standing by him. Keep the family away. I'm looking to shoot through any pervert that lives. Keep the family safe.
Facts. Oh, man. Like, you got to stay away from that shit. And just to give a warning to these people, like, yo, keep your family away from this shady ass pedophile fucker. Like, stay away. Sorry, I'm swearing. But song. But straight up, like, you gotta be careful, people like that. I know I keep saying, but fuck, it's the truth. Like, man, let's get back to it.
D. Dear baby girl, I'm sorry that your father not active inside your world. He don't commit to much, but it's music, yeah, that's for sure. He a narcissist, misogynist, living inside his songs. Try to destroy families rather than taking care of his own. Should be teaching you timetables or watching Frozen with you. Or at your 11th birthday, singing poems with you. Instead, he being Turks, paying for sex and popping perks. Examples that you don't deserve. I want to tell you that you're loved, you're brave, you're kind. You got a gift to change the world and can change your father's mind. Cause our children is the future, but he lives inside confusion. Money's always been illusion, but that's the life he's used to. His father probably didn't claim him neither. History do repeats itself, sometimes it don't need a reason. But I would like to say it's not your fault that he's hiding another child. Give him grace, this the reason I made Mr. Morale. So our babies like you can cope later. Give you some confidence to go through something, it's hope later. I never want to hear you chasing man cause it's failed behavior. Sitting in the club with sugar daddies for validation. You need to know that love is eternity and trumps all pain. I tell you who your father is, just play this song when it rains. Yes, he's a hit maker, songwriter, superstar, right? And a fucking deadbeat that should never say more life. Meet the Grams. Dear Harvey, I know you probably thinking I wanted to crash your party. But truthfully, I don't have a hating bone in my body. This supposed to be a good exhibition within the game. But you fucked up the moment you called out my family's name. Why you had to stoop so low to discredit some decent...
Yeah, don't fucking call someone out. That's... you... Well, if you call someone out, but then you call their family out, like, that... That's just fucked up. Like, you're trying to do something that's not there. Or, like, you're going past what you should be. Like, if there is a beef, like, you should be one-on-one. Like, don't be fucked up in, what's the word I'm looking for? Cowardly. It's cowardly. You're going after... someone's family versus, like, you can't come up with shit, like, in a rap battle towards someone. Like, in fact, like, Kendrick, like I said, is one of the best lyricists. Fucking, he's top tier. Like, he writes his own shit. He knows what he's doing. He is the best. I know I keep saying that, but, like, it's the truth. True.
People guess integrity is lost when the metaphors doesn't reach you, and I like to understand because your house was never a home. 37, but you showing up as a 7-year-old. You got gambling problems, drinking problems, pill popping and spending problems, bad with money, whorehouse, soliciting women problems. Therapy's a lovely start, but I suggest some ayahuasca, strip the ego from the bottom. I try to empathize with you.
Ooh, he's telling him to take my ayahuasca so he can take a trip and fucking maybe really look into himself and seeing the fucked up shit that he's doing and maybe become aware of it. Because when people go out do ayahuasca, they have some life-changing experience. He's telling Drake to fucking have a life-changing experience with ayahuasca. Like, ah, man. Let's get back to it.
Cause I know that you ain't been through nothing. Crave entitlement, but wanna be like so bad that it's puzzling. No dominance. Let's recap moments when you didn't fit in. No secret handshakes with your friend. No culture cachet to binge. Just disrespecting your mother. Identity's on the fence. Don't know which family would love you. The skin that you living in is compromised and personas. Can't channel your masculine even when standing next to a woman. You a body shamer. You go hide them baby mamas, ain't ya? You embarrassed of them. That's not right. That ain't how mama raised us. Take that mask off. I wanna see what's under them achievements. Why believe you? You never gave us nothing to believe in. Cause you lied about religious views. You lied about your surgery. You lied about your accent and your past tense. All is perjury. You lied about your ghost riders. You lied about your crew members. They all pussy. You lied on them. I know they all got you in them. You lied about your son. You lied about your daughter, huh? You lied about them other kids that's out there hoping that you come. You lied about the only artist that can offer you some help. Fuck a rap battle. This a long life battle with yourself.
God damn, that was a therapy session for Drake. Like, straight up, like, therapy. Yeah. Holy shit. Fuck, that was killer. You like, and if I'm right, this was the first one that came out? Oh, there might have been four. I think I heard. But obviously, not like us. That was the last one. But like, oh man, like he took him through the paces. Just like Kendrick, yo, keep making music, fucking keep doing what you're doing. You're the best. Like, oh fuck yeah. And plus I hear fucking metalheads fucking come up on the fucking page and fucking saying, dude, I'm a metalhead, but when I hear Kendrick Lamar, I'm like, I'm fucking listening to this. I feel this shit. Like, they're fucking telling me they're crip walking shit. That's fucking crazy. Like, hey, so, you know, you guys wanted it. I hope you enjoyed it. I'm gonna be more. I'm gonna put more videos out. Sorry, it was a stint. I had to wait to get a mic. Hopefully the sound is a lot better. I'm also testing the level, so hopefully the sound's a lot better than the webcam audio. So hey, if you enjoyed this, like the video, subscribe.